Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to part two of our tutorial series about using JSON data in After Effects with our free extension, mamoworldJSON. Today, we want to link some colors of our project to the JSON file. So our project already has this layer, Color Options, where you can choose the color of all parts of the design. Here we can control the color of the location, for example. So we simply select the color property, and then in the mamoworldJSON panel, we click on Connect. Now we need to enter again the name under which the color should be listed in the JSON file. A great feature of JSON files is that they can group their names in sections. If we write color.location, for example, this means that the color will be stored in the section Color under the name Location. You can even create subsections inside of sections by using multiple dots like mySection.mySubsection.myName. Now we also link the color of the day temperature and enter as a name color.temperatureDay. If we open the JSON file, you can see that a color section has now been added with the color values for location and day temperature. Many text editors allow you to collapse and expand those sections, which helps a lot when editing larger JSON files. You can see that the color values are given as hex codes. If you are not familiar with this format, it is the string that the After Effects color picker shows here at the bottom after the hashtag. If you prefer to set the colors using three separate numbers for red, green, and blue, you can simply replace the value, including the quotes, by square brackets, and then enter three numbers separated by commas like 255, 0, 0. This is interpreted by mamoworldJSON as red, green, and blue values with a range from 0 to 255. So the text is now pure red. Some people also prefer to give color values in the range from 0 to 1 instead of 0 to 255. To indicate that you want a range from 0 to 1 instead of 0 to 255, you can simply add a fourth component to your vector and set it to 1. So 0.5, 0.5, 0.3, 1, for example, means 50% red, 50% green, and 30% blue. So that's how you link colors in your After Effects project to a JSON file. As you have seen, mamoworldJSON is very flexible and supports all kinds of notations for your color values. Also, you've learned how easy it is to group your JSON file into sections. In the next part, we will learn how to control the icons shown here with the help of mamoworldJSON. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com. See you next time.